wave.
Right in the way.
Yeah.
So normally I drive in. So I'll try actually.
Yeah.
Go around there.
That way, isn't it?
So basically, this is London Bridge. It's the most famous landmark of Torbay. It got the name because like people used to come in on paddle steamers from London, and you used to see this first of all, and then they realised that it was. They just said it was just a piece of landmark, and then they started making postcards like bridge magnets, and they started selling it. So they started making money by calling it a home from home. People from London. And it used to work. So everyone who from London came in and went, oh, have you seen London Bridge? And everyone else like, what's that? And then it's this. It's got about 60 years left in it. You see the way it looks rock out. When we go further back, you'll see it's leaning over. So that's the only bit that's holding it up in the middle. Geologists said 60 years. But everyone thinks left. Yeah, they don't know when. One morning it could be there, and next one it might not be.
Shame.
And they've said they want to like try and preserve it, but then everyone's like, don't just leave it.
Let it stay.
If you try and preserve it, it's just going to ruin the coastline.
Yeah.
Like what they've done over there, they can do stuff like that. Yeah. So you've got an old lookout tower up the top. You've got a bonsai tree to the right of it. So the lookout tower is to do with World War II. There's a hotel around the corner called the Osborne. The Osborne, Hitler wanted to buy for himself in the war. So at the end of the war when I went in, very confident,
he was.
That's where he wanted to live, so they never got this side of this tall bay. Whereas in the rest of the bay, it's completely flat. If you go back on it, see how flat it is compared to when we go across the middle, if you look back at here, it's still hilly. And basically that's just a lookout tower, and now it's in the back of someone's garden.
Oh, wow.
He's got it in a drum studio for his pub in the daytime and a cocktail bar at night.
Oh, okay.
I mean, you can't complain about that, can you, really? And then if you look at the rocks as well, this one's an elephant, the face of an elephant. This one at the corner.
Oh, yeah.
Is it? You got
head,
cool. You got the eye, the trunk, and then the ears, that massive in rock, just the whole rock.
Impressive.
You take a photo of it now and you realise what was I looking at there. See it as you go further forwards as well.
Yeah, stand out.
So you get free climbers, they climb a lot along the coast here. They've been doing it because it's not going to be the best of weather. So it's about 5 metres of water all the way along here, even on a high tide. I know that from that enough, from being here all the time. And then this is the only way across. So they've got the ropes that hang down, and they use these lines to swing across. They're not what they look like. They do look a bit dodgy. We call this Thunder Cove in here. Because all the waves get pushed in, and when it's choppy, it sounds like thunder at the back of it.
Wow.
This cove's got this part of this. It's always the only place that's got a name, so we call it Thunder Cove because of it. Then everyone's just adapted to it. around this rock here, you'll see Thatcher Rock in the distance. It's the big rock, the big first rock you can see. And as we go around the corner, I'll point out the Osborne as well.
Does the Osborne hold the manicured lawn?
No, that's the guy's house.
Yeah. Oh my.
The Osborne's the one around the corner, the big yellow crescent.
My.
Especially to wake everyone up. This is called Thatcher Rock here. It's a protected island for like birds and seagulls. Seagulls mainly live on here, and cormorants. So cormorants are the blackbirds, and then you get grey ones, which are shags, and then you get the old white belly one as well, which is a 1 in 20 cormorant. And they look like they're wearing a little dinner suit. So if you see one, you'll see what I'm on about. But I don't know if there's... There might be one on the other side. Hopefully... Oh, there's one just there.
Oh, yeah.
He's wearing his suit.
That's funny.
You can see like how many there are compared to the other ones.
Yeah.
So cormorants, they can dive up to 40 meters underwater.
Wow.
And they can do that in under 2 minutes. And they use their wings to push themselves.
Yeah.
And they can hold their breath up to 10 minutes.
Wow.
Amazing.
They always stand very tall, the white belly ones. And when they've got their wings out, they look like a little dragon, I would say.
Well, the very little birds just come across the water, the heavy
Guillemots,
yeah. That's the one.
There's none, they're not here at the moment because they've all finished their nesting season.
Right.
They all sit on the yawstone on the side. They sit here in the winter and then they just disappear and then they come back again. Now, literally, one day you'll look at the rock and there'll be nothing there. Next day, it'll be up full, right? Like, where you come from. It's amazing to see when they're there and then when you start going there and they start like limiting out. And I went the other week and there were like two there. And they're all around on the water.
Yeah.
So they're back to being seabirds again. You got my house in front.
Yeah.
I wish.
That's the one, yeah.
The garden doesn't look that impressive today.
No.
It's got all the yellow on it. Normally it's cut in straight lines and you can see the grass being cut. And it looks like that all year round as well. Well, the garden's probably been sacked, so. But the house isn't that impressive. It's the garden that's more impressive. It's got one side that you go around the corner. You can see it from Berry Head. You can see it all the way around the bay. If I told you about how much it was worth, it would make you feel sick. 17.5 million. The average house at the top of Torquay up there is 2 million plus. It's the most expensive part of Torbay. Well, you just see the houses behind that house as well. Get seals around here as well. I'd like to go and see if there was any. They normally sit inside the rocks. So from here, I'm going to go over towards Berry Head. We're probably going to go about 2 miles off Berry Head and see if there's anything out there. It'll be about 10 minutes, so we might get a bit of a splash of water. I won't get you soaked, I promise. Right, are we all good to go? If you keep your eyes peeled, if you see anything, just shout me.
still going.
Which way to go?
They're all
three of them
there.
Oh, yeah.
So when I turn up, turn around, they pop up.
Yeah, you can see those over there as well. There's these three there. This is major.
To last time, and the time before that I did the
jet ski. It's just something different. Do you see dolphins on the map?
No. No.
It's too calm. Just chilling. Yeah. They look like they're fishing, because they're going in circles.
The
one's
really small, so is it more than
that? Yes, there you go,
yeah.
Yeah, I didn't see the bit. I can flip it because this is going in the water in a second.
Gone. Come over this side. Maybe it's starting to come over as well. So. There's one on this side now. One on the front left hand side now. It's always the way, isn't it? Oh. Look like there's people out there. Go out there where all those birds are.